And welcome to Globe Academy's first news report. My name is Achiku Towe and I'm here to report on the fantastic journey that we have taken as an academy since the start of September. We'll first hear from Mr. Jones, who's going to report on the Ofsted results.
Hi everybody, I'm here to talk about our very successful Ofsted that we had at the end of October. There are four main things that came out of the Ofsted that I'm really proud of. Firstly, behaviour was outstanding. We knew that, and people work hard together to make sure that is the case. And thank you, students, for your wonderful behaviour on the 2 days, but for generally your behaviour around the school, which is outstanding. Teaching was consistently good or outstanding, and I'm very proud of the work that all the teachers put in on a daily basis to make sure that students get the very, very best lessons. One comment from the inspectors that really surprised me, which was really pleasing, was one inspector in particular said it is the best culture and ethos that she'd ever seen, and that's down to everybody coming together around those 2 days to make sure that everybody saw that Globe is a really special place to be. However, as you know, we've still got work to do, and in achieving our mission of preparing students for university and to be leaders in their community, but we've got off to a really, really great start, and I know it's going to continue. I just want to personally thank the whole community, all the adults who work here, all the children for the hard work that they do, and finally to have a great Christmas and a restful Christmas, and make sure you come back ready and raring for the new year ahead.
As you all know, our sixth form opened this September. At our opening ceremony, we had guests such as Nick Gibb, MP, we had Paul Marshall and Lucy Heller, Head of ARC. The ceremony was a fantastic testament to what we aim to do over the next 2 years. We will now hear from Miss Baldwin, Dean of Sixth Form.
So Sixth Form has been going from strength to strength. We started in September and we have had some incredible times together. One highlight for me was our residential, where we took all of Sixth Form away together as a big family, and we got to go to the Norfolk coast and just spend some time together, just thinking through what we want our Sixth Form experience to look like. And then we got to go to Cambridge University, which again was a really exciting opportunity for us to see how universities work and what is in store for our future. So Sixth Forms have had a fantastic time this year, just getting to grips with their A-levels and getting to grips with what it means to be an independent worker. There's been some highs, there's been some lows, but we're really excited about the future and what it's going to bring.
Thanks to Miss Rigby, who introduced our spoken words poetry, and now have a look at these fantastic poems our students have created.
Right hand to the floor.
Right hand!
Does he deserve it? Does he deserve to be judged by the colour of his skin? Whether he's white, mixed race or black? Why does this colour of your skin depend on how you're treated? Stereotypes be like, if you're black, you're beaten. If you're white, you get treated nice. Think about that boy that you called a terrorist the other day. Is he laughing? No. He's probably crying. Because did you know the fact that he has a member of his family in Palestine with bombs flying over their head as they fight for their life? Where's the laughter now? The other day, I heard a story about a young 12-year-old black boy in America who was shot to death for holding a fake gun. What about his mother? She's probably thinking, son, why did you leave me so soon? And every night she looks up at the moon with tears rolling down her cheeks and she thinks, why him? But let's be real, if that was the same boy but with skin that's not the colour of black, he'd still be alive today. Because of the colour of your skin, people are being killed day after day. Is there really no other way? Are these the things that Nelson Mandela, Malcolm X and Rosa Parks fought for? Is this what they meant by opening a new door? Why should he be left alone on the cold floor? Because he's not alone. Now it's time for us to stand up against the things that people are saying, because we're not playing. I thought racism was abolished, so why does it still exist? How do you expect these young kids to see through all this mist? And how do you expect them to do this alone when there's no one there to assist? So my brothers and sisters, whether you're white, black, mixed race or brown, don't let anyone put you down, because there will always be humanity by your side.
Yeah! Remembrance Day was a true indication to what students at Globe Academy are capable of. We would now like to thank all those students who played an important role with the planning and the execution of the ceremony on the 11th of November. We will now watch a short video which shows the highlights of that special day.
Around the world today, people are still suffering, dying in the name of war.
You will be queen. Today we remember those from countries across the world who lost so many in the First World War.
Million lives lost, 20 million people wounded, 900 British and Commonwealth soldiers killed.
Tonga, Fiji, Bangladesh,
Cyprus,
Maldives, St. Kitts,
2-1.
Students working together seeped into the primary school when we began student-led mentoring. Students across the whole academy mentored 20 students in year 5 and year 6 in order to help them improve their literacy and numeracy skills. Everyone involved is learning a lot, and the mentors especially are having a positive impact on the primary school children's attainment. The mock exams took place over a 2-week period. All students involved were commended for their strong professionalism throughout. The feedback gained from the mock exams are crucial for our success over the coming months.
Overall, I think the mocks were a good eye-opener to see where I am academically, to see what I need to do to improve. Overall, I think I need to revise in geography and English. And yeah, I got another 6 months to continue, so hopefully I'll do my best.
Enrichment Day took place last week and was a success.
Your time to nominate some of your top teachers this term.
My best teacher this term has been Mr. Thompson, because he has helped me through a lot of hard times and he persevered even when it seems that I'm not trying.
Mr. Maxwell, because his lessons are very fun and he's very calm.
My favourite teacher is Ms. Sukun, because she helps us learn every day, and also she's very supportive every time we come to her lessons.
Ms. Brown, because she makes me work better.
My favourite teacher is Ms. Wardering, because she doesn't give a lot of C points.
And she makes it fun.
Ms. Miggins, because I've learnt a lot this term.
My favourite teacher is Miss Smith, because she really helped me with English, because I started from like a very low set, and she built my confidence up in English. And she loves poetry, and she made me love poetry even more.
My favourite teacher used to be Miss Brown, but now it's Miss Swain, because she can understand my problems, she can get me out of trouble, and she sits down and have a talk.
Ryan, yes.
It may be Christmas, but it's a sad time for some. We have to say goodbye to some of our favourite teachers. We wish them all the best and thank you for teaching us.
I've had a great 4 years at Globe Academy. I'll miss you all and wish you all the very best for your future. Keep reading.
Hi Globe Academy. To all the students at Globe Academy, I'll definitely miss you. You're a fantastic bunch of students. I hope you great success in the future. I know my year 11s are really going to miss me too. year 12s, but I know that with what I've started you with, you have great teachers who can continue the mantle. Bye.
Okay, my best bits at Globe Academy, there are many. I love to teach students at Globe Academy, particularly my current Year 11 students. They are inspiring, very lively, and I'm pretty sure they will achieve fantastic outcomes. Other best bits at Globe are student performances. For example, the Black History Month performance was outstanding, it was very inspiring. All the performances that we've had organised by the music and drama department were just amazing, and I've never ever seen anything like that in any other schools. Students who are likely to be prime ministers, I think there's a few. Ryan Coakley in year 12, I have high hopes for that young man. Then Adi in year 11, our head boy, is an outstanding leader. Antoine, also very, very, he's got a particular way of seeing things that's very inspiring. And obviously Zareen, our head girl, pretty sure they will, you know, achieve some great things. Proudest moment at Globe. I think it has to be seeing the community come together as a family during those performances, and seeing everybody come together and being part of that was extremely humbling and very pleasing. So I'd be missing students, I'd be missing the staff at Globe, but I'm going to move into another school in London, and I will be in touch and hopefully visiting Globe many, many times. So thank you very much.
Happy Christmas, everyone. I just wanted to say the best bits for me this year were definitely the Remembrance event. It was really nice to see all the students outside participating in the event, and in particular, I remember the year sixes when the balloons went up, the look of awe and wonder in their eyes. I've really enjoyed the last term, and I just wanted to say it's been great working with all of you, and goodbye and good luck.
Merry Christmas, everyone, and a Happy New Year.
Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.